Hello friends, welcome to this vocabulary learning session by PROMAC. I am Narsi Reddy, and in today's session we will learn some words beginning with letter H in English language. We will start today's session with a word hilarious. The word hilarious can be used to describe a person's speech, an attitude, or a general situation. That movie was hilarious. The comments made by this person are hilarious. The situation was hilarious. Anything hilarious is very, very, very funny. Something that makes you laugh, something that creates laughter, either because it is very jocular or because it is very strange. You get laughter either because something is very positive and it made you laugh in a good way, or something is very strange and it made you laugh in a strange manner. Either way, we can say something is hilarious. When we take hilarious as something that is funny or something that makes you laugh, in the meaning of funny or making you laugh, as a synonym of hilarious, we can learn many other words: risible, droll, amusing, humorous, so risible, droll, amusing, humorous. All these words mean anything that makes you laugh, something that creates laughter. But sometimes some things make you laugh because they are very, very strange. They are very, very abnormal. They are very, very unbelievable, or they are very awkward. Hey, your dress sense is ridiculous. Your accent is ludicrous. When I heard the price you paid for this car, I was shocked and I found it very ridiculous. So ridiculous, ludicrous, burlesque, farcical, absurd. So ridiculous, ludicrous, burlesque, farcical, absurd. All these words are taken in the meaning of anything that makes you laugh because it is very, very strange, abnormal, unbelievable, or awkward, then we call all these things. Your hairstyle is very absurd. Your behavior is very absurd. The situation was very farcical. So something that made you laugh because it is very strange or abnormal. When we talk about anything that makes you laugh, in the meaning of a play or a drama or a situation or any art form that makes you laugh, we can take many words: comedy, cartoon, caricature, satire, lampoon, parody, spoof, com. So these are all some words which are used to describe certain forms that make you laugh. Comedy or cartoon, I don't think I need to explain comedy or cartoon, you all know what it is. Caricature, caricature basically means a funny portrait or a funny representation of something. When you see a cartoon or in some television programs, you have some character or some person who is actually a comical representation of somebody else. So you can understand, okay, this guy is imitating that famous person and they are creating laughter. Then we say it is a caricature of that famous person. Caricature is a funny portrait. By imitating somebody in a ridiculing manner, you create humor, or by imitating something, you create humor. There is a famous movie called James Bond or James Bond series. Imitating James Bond series, there is another series called Austin Powers. Austin Powers is a satire on James Bond. Austin Powers movies are a parody of James Bond. Austin Powers movies lampoon James Bond. They spoof. So parody, lampoon, spoof or satire is a program or any art form or any drama or anything where you are creating humor by imitating something or by presenting something in a laughing manner. Then that is called satire, lampoon, parody or spoof. Sitcom. Sitcom is a word that came from situation comedy. So what are sitcoms? I am sure many of you watch television programs like How I Met Your Mother or Anger Management or Rules of Engagement or Two and a Half Men or Big Bang Theory. In all these things, what they do, they have a situation and from that situation they are providing humor. So all these television programs like Big Bang Theory or Two and a Half Men or Rules of Engagement, they are all what are called sitcoms, situation comedy. As you can see, the word sitcom came from combining two different words and I have created a word, or we are learning a word called sitcom. What do we call these type of words? There are many words where you are combining two words and creating another word. You combine breakfast and lunch and you create a word called brunch. You create a word called brunch. You combine situation comedy and you come out with a word called sitcom. These kind of words are called portmanteaus. When you read the dictionary meaning of portmanteau, it is given as a type of bag or suitcase which can be split into two parts when needed. So there are some types of bag or a suitcase which you can split into two parts. But the same word which means portmanteau is also used in these kind of things. I am combining two different words and I am coming out with a word which is a combination of these two words. These type of things are also called a portmanteau. Sometimes there are some compound words where the two words adjacent to each other are opposite in meaning. Suppose you have a movie called True Lies. So here if you see this word called True Lies, true cannot be lie, lie cannot be true. But there is a word called True Lies. There is something called a kind terrorist. What do you mean by a kind terrorist? Somebody cannot be kind and cannot be a terrorist. So these kind of words are what are called an oxymoron. So what is an oxymoron? An oxymoron is a word that is formed by combining two exact opposite words. Oxymoron is a word that is formed by combining two exact opposite words is what is called oxymoron. So we have discussed a word called hilarious. Hilarious means very, very funny, and from this we have learned some more words. Next word we will learn is a word called hinterland. What does this word hinterland mean? Today the word hinterland is taken in the meaning of a remote area, anything that is an underdeveloped area. See, in the old days, water was very, very, very important for civilization, because in the old days the professions were agriculture, cattle breeding and fishing. Agriculture needed water, cattle breeding needed water, fishing obviously needs water, and even the trade used to be through ships, and water was very, very important for trade also. So almost all major cities in the world are always on the bank of a river, sea or a water body. New York is on the bank of a river. Washington DC is on the bank of a river. New Delhi is on the bank of a river. Berlin is on the bank of a river. So almost all major cities in the world are always on the bank of a river or a water body. So anything that is near to a water body is considered a civilized place. So it is considered a central place. Anything that is away from water is considered an underdeveloped or remote place. If you see hinterland, many dictionaries may give a meaning called non-coastal or away from water. But today, anything that is remote, underdeveloped, hinterlands of India, hinterlands of that country, hinterlands of that state, so hinterland is a very, very remote or underdeveloped area or inaccessible area. What do we call something that is on the bank of a river? So we call it as riparian. Riparian city. Riparian city is a city which is on the bank of a river. But riparian is also taken as anything related to river water. Let us discuss about riparian issues between these two countries. So riparian is anything related to river water. So we learnt a word called hinterland. Hinterland means non-coastal, away from water, or anything that is underdeveloped. Another word we will learn is hindrance. What is hindrance? I have faced many hindrances in my effort to do this. So hindrance is nothing but an obstacle. Anything that tries to prevent. What is hinder? Hinder is to stop or prevent. I wanted to start my own company, but lack of money hindered my efforts to become an entrepreneur. So hinder is to prevent or obstruct. Hindrance is any obstruction or obstacle. The next word we will take up is a word called hirsute. Hirsute is, there are some people, they have lot of body hair on their chest, on their hands, on their face, shoulders. There is very, very, very bushy and thick hair. So hirsute is basically hairy. He is a very hirsute person. Hirsute means having a lot of hair at different parts of the body or all over the body. That's all. There is nothing much to explain about this word. The next word we will take up is histrionics. Histrionics basically means acting skills. So histrionics basically means acting skills. So this word can be used either in a positive way or in a slightly non-positive way. Yesterday I watched a movie. I was really impressed by the histrionic skills of the actors who acted in that movie. Even though this guy is very young and inexperienced, his histrionic skills are amazing. Histrionics is acting skills. But suppose somebody, I am sitting in my office, one of my staff members comes and says, "Sir, you know, sir, I am very sick, sir, I want to leave, sir." Something, he is putting some artificial pretense. Then I say, "Hey, cut out your histrionics and do what you want to do. Please don't act in front of me. Don't bullshit me. Don't present something that is false." So histrionics is also taken in the meaning of an insincere pretense, an insincere behavior, or anything that is not genuine in behavior or attitude. Next word we will take up is hoard. What is hoard? Somebody is hoarding lot of money. This year agriculture season was not very good, and they are expecting a shortage of that crop. So many traders, with the objective of enhancing their profits, they are hoarding the stocks. This person is hoarding the shares of that company because he wants to make a huge profit by selling them when they go up. So you are hoarding something. I am hoarding money. I am hoarding wealth. I am hoarding gold. I am hoarding food grains. Hoarding is collect or accumulate in large number. Collect or accumulate in large number, mostly for some purpose. Either you want to make a profit at a later date, or you are trying to create an artificial shortage, or you are trying to benefit from it. So you are hoarding it. Hoarding is accumulate or collect something in large quantity or large number or more than required quantity. Another word we will take up is hoary. The word hoary comes from hover. So we all know what is a horoscope. What is a horoscope? So in many countries, people believe that if I know the time and date of a person's birth, from that I can understand what will be that person's future like. So I want to read your horoscope. Horoscope is anything that tells about a person's life based on the time of the birth. So what is hoary? Hoary is very, very, very old. Anything belonging to a long time. My hair has become white because I am a hoary person. Something is a hoary past. I don't want to understand the hoary past of this company. So this company has been in existence for many centuries. I don't want to understand what all they have done 100 years ago, 200 years ago. Hoary is anything that is old with age, anything coming from a long time, or anything that is white with age or very, very old. So the unit called hour is also coming from this only. Next word is hawks. What is hawks? Somebody calls me saying that, "Mister, there is a bomb in your office." Immediately I call the police, I call the bomb squad, then they check up, then they find that there is no bomb. Then they say, "Okay, somebody made a phone call claiming something bogus." So the bomb threat was a hoax. So and so was a hoax. So hoax is anything that is bogus, fake, not genuine or not true, is what is called a hoax. Another word we will take up is holocaust. The word holocaust is a very, very important word in history. If you see the dictionary meaning of this word called holocaust, you will read the meaning as a massive destruction by fire. Any huge fire accident which destroys is called holocaust. In the same meaning as a large fire, we can also take another word called conflagration. Conflagration also means massive fire or large scale destruction by fire. But the word holocaust is used to describe the unfortunate incident in the world history where Hitler supposed killed a large number of Jews. So that killing of Jews in Germany during the time of Hitler is also called Jewish Holocaust. So holocaust is large-scale destruction by fire, or that massive killing of Jews by Hitler is what is called Holocaust. Next word we will take up is holster. What is holster? Police officers, military officers, or security guards generally carry a gun. So the gun is kept in a leather cover and typically is attached to their belt or something like that. So the leather cover in which a gun is kept is what is called a holster. The word holster sounds very similar to a word called bolster. Hey, why did you join my training session? You know I wanted to bolster my confidence. I want to bolster my score. I wanted to bolster my knowledge. So bolster is to strengthen, enhance, or make better. Another word, polster, also sounds very similar to this. The word polster, or another word called cephalologist. What is a polster or a cephalologist? There are some people, whenever an election occurs in any democratic process, there are some analysts or specialists, they will be analyzing the trends of voting and they will be making some predictions about who will win, who will not win, etc. The people who make predictions about elections or who analyze elections are called pollster or cephalologist. A pollster or a cephalologist is a person who studies election trends, or a person who analyzes election trends is called a pollster. Another word is homage. What is homage? Homage is typically used when we talk about a person who died. Suppose a great man died, a great politician or a scientist or a scholar or an artist or any actor, etc. died. Then everybody will go and say, oh, he was a very great man. His death is a great loss to the society. His death cannot be fulfilled. We are very sorry. So they will say a lot of positive words about the dead person. So this is called paying homage to a person. Homage is any positive comments or praise or respect that is shown towards a dead person, or any positive comments made about a dead person is what is called homage. But homage probably is also used to describe praise given to a person, but mostly it is. There is also another word called tribute. So lot of people paid their tribute to the great man who died yesterday. So you are paying your tribute, you are paying your homage, that means you are paying your respect to a dead person. The next word we will take up is homily. Many times you can take homily, discourse, or sermon as synonyms. Homily, discourse, or sermon are generally used in the meaning of a religious or moral lecture. When we go to a church, when we go to a temple, when we go to a mosque, there is a religious person and they will be giving some religious speech. My children, you have to do this, you have to live like this, otherwise you will go to hell. If you do this, you will go to heaven. So that moral lecture or religious lecture is what is called a sermon, discourse, or homily. But in any religious lecture, you also see a warning. You are all sinners. Because you are all sinners, you will go to hell. So and so bad things will happen. So please do this. Please get corrected. Please get reformed. So lot of times, a religious lecture also is giving you a strict warning to mend your ways, to become better, etc. So a lot of times homily, discourse, or sermon is also given as a strict warning or a criticizing speech where somebody is giving you a warning to become better or correct yourself. So somebody, my teacher gave a discourse to me. Today my dad gave a sermon to me. Today my mom gave a homily to me. So homily, discourse or sermon is a religious or moral lecture, or could also be a criticizing speech or a speech which gives a strict warning. Next word we will take up is hone. Hey, what are you doing? I am trying to hone my communication skills. I am trying to hone my computer skills. I am trying to hone my acting skills. I am trying to hone my teaching skills. Hone is basically to sharpen, to make better. Hone is to sharpen or to make better or improve something is what is called hone. Not much to explain here, so we have just learnt this word. Next word we will learn is hoodwink. Somebody hoodwinked me. Hoodwink is to cheat or to deceive. Somebody hoodwinked you means they have cheated you or they have deceived you or they have misled you. Another word we will take up is a word called hortatory. What is hortatory? To understand the word hortatory, we can also learn another word that came from this exhort. The president exhorted the youth of this country to work for the country. The president exhorted the people of the country to join the army and fight for the country. What is exhort? To encourage, to motivate, to give a speech or a comment which motivates people, which encourages people, which forces people to do something. So any motivating speech, encouraging speech, where you are encouraging or motivating people to do something, that kind of a speech is called a hortatory speech. The military commander gave a hortatory speech to the soldiers, asking them to fight for the country and gain victory. So that's what is called hortatory. Very, very enthusiastic speech which motivates or provokes people to do something. Next word we will take up is hostile. That person is very hostile towards me. I could never understand why you are hostile towards me. That country is making some hostile advances towards my country. Hostile is unfriendly. Anything that shows their hatred towards you or somebody is hostile towards you means they are very unfriendly, they are your enemies, they are showing their ill will or animosity towards you is what is called hostile. The next word we will take up is hovel. Hovel is used to describe a house or a room or any small hut which is very, very small, very, very cramped or very dirty or not very clean, not very comfortable. I thought you live in a beautiful house, but today when I came and saw the hovel you are living in, I am shocked, I am surprised. Why are you living in this hovel? So hovel is a small hut, very, very dirty, ugly, uncomfortable place, which is typically a shelter of somebody, is what is called a hovel. Another word we will take up is hover. While the person was undergoing the surgery, the relatives and family members are hovering near the operation theater. While I was doing this work, my children were hovering near me. What is hover? Moving in the surroundings or waiting for something, you are hovering around something. Hovering around is moving around or generally surrounding something, or even after something is over. While I was getting the work done, the people are still hovering near the coffee shop, hovering near the water cooler. So hovering is moving around or staying around for doing something is what is called hover. The next word is hubris. What is hubris? We all should be confident and believe in ourselves. Sometimes the confidence becomes too much and it will become overconfidence. If it exceeds even the level of overconfidence, nothing can happen to me. Nobody can do anything to me. Nobody can defeat me. I can never lose. I am a great man. Then that extreme overconfidence is what is called hubris. Hubris is extreme overconfidence, extreme complacence, extreme self-satisfaction with one's own achievements or capabilities is what is called hubris. The next word is humus. What is humus? We have some plants and other organic matter. How soil becomes fertile? All these plants and organic matter, after they die, they become rotten. After they become rotten, they become very, very, very soft substance, and that gives fertility to the soil. So humus is that soft substance. When organic matter disintegrates, deteriorates, forms that very soft matter which gives fertility to the soil, that's what is called humus. So humus is basically the soft matter which comes from decaying or destruction of organic matter, disintegration of organic matter. Next word we will take up is hurtle. What does this word hurtle mean? If you have seen, there is a mountain or there is a hillock like this. Suddenly because of something, some stones or the rocks will be falling down the side of the mountain. How do they fall? They are rolling down and they are suddenly coming and falling. Or sometimes, unfortunately, there is a train accident. When a train accident occurs, how does the train fall? One after the other, it will fall. So the type of falling of a rock or a stone or a train when a train accident occurs, that's what is called hurtle. Hurtling down the mountain. What is hurtling down the mountain? Moving around or falling with a very sudden motion, abrupt motion, is what is called hurtle. Next word we will take up is a word called hyperbole. So hyperbole is a very, very, very exaggerated, boastful speech. You speak some things which are very, very, very exaggerated, very, very, very boastful. You talk a lot about something, then that is what is called hyperbole. Hyperbole is exaggerated speech or very, very, very unbelievably boastful speech is what is called hyperbole. It's always used when we talk about speech. Next word we will take up is hypochondriac. Hypochondriac is a word which is related to illness. We all become sick. When we talk about sickness, there are three types of people. Some people are really sick. Of course, we call them sick. Sometimes I am not really sick, but I pretend to be sick with the objective of avoiding duty or avoiding work. Today I don't want to go to office. I don't want to work. So I simply call my boss and say, "Hey sir, today I am suffering from the flu. Today I am suffering from cold. So I cannot come to the office. Actually, I don't have any flu or cold, but I claim, I pretend to be ill with the objective of avoiding work or avoiding duty." When a person is pretending to be sick with the objective of avoiding work, that guy is called a malingerer. What is malingerer? Malingerer is pretending to be sick with the objective of avoiding duty or work. But there are some people, they are really not sick, but they imagine illness. They are quite healthy, But every day they are thinking, okay, I have this health problem, I have that health problem. Every day they are. So anybody who is imagining illnesses is what is called a hypochondriac. What is a hypochondriac? A person who suffers from imaginary sickness or imaginary illnesses. So friends, we have learned some words starting with letter H in English language. I hope you have understood. Please write to us with any feedback at our email ID promaccoaching@gmail.com.